considered a show as hell, and the upper was just considered like a paradise where we get a lot of our mythology from.
Yes.
And so he went there, and he gave those people a second chance. And a lot of them, and we hold people like probably Solomon that died in idol worship, and all these other people that had a second chance to accept him. You know, this is speculation.
That just floored me when I read that.
Thing. Yeah, because he did, and what he has told me too, because I had this big thing about even talking to aliens, and I'm not talking about the Greys and all those, and the I'm talking about the humanoid ones, the Nordics, some of these different branches of the Anunnaki, and what he told me was this: is that they can have redemption, but they don't have, they're not saved by the blood, like we are humans are. We're saved by his blood,
mm-hmm.
but they can be. They can be redeemed. They can have a second chance at, accepting him and following him.
Mm-hmm. That's
why, because you look at Mark and says, "Preach the gospel to every creature." You're like, well, I'm supposed to go to turtles and frogs mm-hmm. and preach.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think that's what that means. But I think it also means that although mankind has salvation, these fallen beings that had children can be redeemed. Their children's can be redeemed.
Well, apparently there was some preaching going on when he was quickened in the spirit.
Yeah.
And Peter says that was after he died in the flesh. So that was wild. Well, thank you for that. I really appreciate your insight onto that one.
Yeah. So I do think that these watchers, these aliens, that they can accept redemption from him. They can have a second chance. Not the same salvation we have, because they don't need saved by the blood. They're not, but they can... have a second chance.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's part of a ministry that's coming up ahead of time, probably in the future for me, is dealing more in the aspect of dealing with these fallen angels' kids.
Mm-hmm.
I think I can see that coming, and so I don't know how much longer I'll have just doing this, what I'm doing here, the radio shows, the websites and stuff. I think I have another mission coming up sooner or later.
Well,
and
so, I would imagine so. I think that's the way God works, right?
Yeah, I mean...
Tries you out in one thing and then moves you to the next.
Move to the next, because I've done everything he's asked me to do here. I've done everything he's asked me to do. I'm done.
Yeah.
And so it's like, okay, let's get on to the next. And I know that this whole thing with Matria coming, there's going to be some real fireworks. People need to, settle in and brace themselves.
Well, thank you so much for what you do for humanity, really, but for Christians that are trying to make they see something going on in the dogma, they're trying to make a breakaway, but there's really no place to go.
Yeah, you just go to him.
You can switch between, churches or whatever, but you really have to jump off the edge of the, the edge of the cliff or whatever and just jump right out there into no man's land.
Yep, in the wilderness with him, and you're all alone and just learning, and then
yeah.
he'll lead you to
and
his people.
It's pretty set up that way, isn't it? It's pretty well set up to where, you got this uncomfortable but fellowship thing going on with this group of people, but, really you have to get out there alone.
Yeah, but you know what? We're going to have a riot when we're together. When we're together, we're going to have a riot. There's going to be no more of this long-distance relationship stuff and only being able to talk to your friends on the Internet. We're going to be together day in and day out kicking butt, and that's when the real fun starts.
Hey, let's do it. I'll look forward to that, Sherry. God bless you for everything that you do.
All right, well,
thank you. Continue to listen and keep doing what you're doing.
Thanks a lot, and thanks for calling in.
Okay.
All right, God bless.
Uh-huh.
Listener call in line, folks, 260-356-2611. And, listen, looking through this stuff, enjoyed the call-ins tonight. Hope that storm holds off in Indiana that's threatening to hit Steve. He said there might be a lot of clicks on the phone. It's like, it's always clicks on the phone.
Yep, we're still here.
You said to watch out for the clicks on the phone, Steve. It's like, there's always clicks on the phone.
That's true. I meant abnormal clicks.
Yeah, we know what the other ones are from. Anything abnormal would be the weather. But I hope it holds off, because, we had 90, 95, 97-degree weather today and yesterday, which usually means we're going to have some vicious storms coming. Usually when it gets really muggy like that, then we're going to have some vicious storms ourselves. And it's tornado season. And so that's not that I don't live in the tornado belt, but we do have this tornado season in the summer times. And so what I did was I hit our whole outlying area with Orgone, so that by the time it hits those areas that have Orgone in them, they pretty much just chill out to nothing. Kind of skip over this area, go hit somebody else. I need to get more areas and further out, but I can't do it all, folks. You know, I can only do so much, and then I've done a lot, so... back to this whole... And I'm going to keep talking about this guy because he is dangerous, this Raymond Watkins and this whole movement he's building. He's dangerous. And he's the thing about him is he's not just a fly-by-night guy, folks. He's very well prepared. He has course instruction material for his students. He's preaching hate under the guise of love. He's preaching only black Israel can be saved. Jesus said, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Sure.
And I believe that whosoever means all. Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt you. you got a caller.
Okay, go ahead and put him on.
You're up.
Hey, Sherry, it's Daryl calling from Atlanta.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing wonderful, and you?
Oh, I'm doing real good.
I just wanted to comment to the gentleman who called before and remark to a comment you made a couple weeks ago with regard to when Christ comes back, he's coming back with a vengeance to clean house. But the first comment is to the gentleman who called a little bit ago. He sounds very much like myself. He sounds like a very emotional person, sounds like he's very intense, and he's really searching. And I think he needs to recognize that, as we all do, just like you just said a minute ago, that each and every one of us have our own relationship, our own ways about relating to God. And some of us, you know, relate differently, just as a gentleman just now, a little bit more reserved and laid back compared to what I felt versus the other gentleman. So, you know, just the fact that you're learning is proof to the fact that, and the fact that you're learning, and you're learning what you're teaching, and on your own, you know. I was led to this alien agenda many years ago myself, although I never had the guts to put it into print like you have. And the other comment I wanted to make was people that when you say that he's coming back with a vengeance to clean house, I think people need to understand, those who are seeking his faith and those who are seeking knowledge, whether they have all the answers or not, is not important. The fact that they're seeking is proof, and that they need to understand that Christ is not upset at them, and that he's not coming back to kick their tails, and that he's coming back, you know, to clean house of those who are not paying any attention to the truth whatsoever, who allowed themselves to be deceived spiritually through the deception that's happening in this world.
Yeah, he's not coming to build a temple in the desert.
Right.
He's not coming back to rule the wrongs of earth. He's not coming back to revamp our economic system. He's coming back to kick butt. And you know what? He's had it. This world is ripe for his judgment. He came the first time as a suffering Messiah. Even the ancient Jews of old could not understand that one Messiah would come and play two different roles at two different times, but it would be the same Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's where this prophet Yahweh is, well, Raymond Watkins. I hate calling him that, prophet Yahweh. I just hate it. He's not a prophet. He's a CIA operation.
Uh-huh.
They can't understand that it's one Messiah, two different roles. And the second one is the conquering one, and that is the one that the Jews expected when he came the first time, to save them from their Roman oppression.
Mm-hmm.
Well, guess what? He's coming to save us from alien oppression.
Oh, yeah.
You think he's coming to save us from alien oppression? There's going to be a hostile takeover here.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? Even reading all this garbage from the New Age movement, you know, how they're coming goodwill toward man, they're going to revamp our economics, we're all going to be rich, and we're all going to be this and that and the other. No, they're not coming. You know what? The one thing I've seen over and over and over again in the Bible codes is that they come with fire, and I don't know if that's literal or symbolic,
mm-hmm.
where they actually come shooting their weapons, but it is a hostile takeover.
Mm-hmm.
And
do you actually think that we'll be here when this happens? I don't.
Do I think we'll be here?
Even be here?
Yes.
Really?
For an extent of it, yes.
Part
to
of
an
it,
extent.
I think part of it, maybe the early parts of it.
Part of it. The early part of it, what I believe is...